हेलो एंड वेलकम टू द अनदर ई लर्निंग सेशन ऑफ पोलियो वायरस। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी विल स्टार्ट विद द क्लासिफिकेशन। पोलियो वायरस बिलोंग्स टू द फैमिली पिकोरनाविरिडी विच हैविंग अ टू मेजर ग्रुप। द वन एंड इम्पोर्टेंट इज एंट्रोवायरस। एंट्रोवायरस हैविंग अ वेरियस सीरोटाइप्स। अमंग दिस द मोस्ट इम्पोर्टेंट एंड द मेजर सीरोटाइप इज पोलियो वायरस दैट हैविंग 1, 2, 3 सब टाइप्स। देन देर इज अनदर सीरोटाइप दैट इज द कोक्साकी वायरसेस। देन इको वायरस। देन पेरेको वायरस एंड एंट्रो वायरसेस दैट इज ऑफ 68 to 116 सीरोटाइप। Then another broad group of Picornaviridae is rhinoviruses that are transmitted by the respiratory route and it can cause the common cold. Then morphology. Picornaviruses are simple in structure. They are very small in size, that is of 28 to 30 nanometer, and they are non-enveloped. They are spherical in shape and having a icosahedral symmetry. You can see in this picture. There is a symmetry is icosahedral. Then capsids is made up of 60 subunit of 4 viral proteins, that is VP1, VP2, VP3 and VP4, except the pericoviruses that having a 3 proteins. Then this possesses a single stranded positive sense linear RNA. Then types of the antigen. There are 3 types of the antigen. One is first one is type 1. It is the most common serotype to cause the epidemics of poliomyelitis. This serotype is responsible for all the natural cases of polio occurring globally. Then type 2, it's the most antigenic in nature, and hence it is the easiest serotype to be eradicated. No natural cases of polio virus caused by serotype type 2 has been reported since 1999. However, the vaccine strain can be caused poliomyelitis, and it is the most common serotype found among the VDVP strain, that is the vaccine derived poliovirus strain. Then type 3. No natural cases is caused by the type 3 has been reported since 2013. However, the vaccine strain have the potential to cause paralytic poliomyelitis. It is considered the most common serotype to cause the VAPP, that is vaccine associated paralytic poliomyelitis. There are two another antigen, that is C and D. D is associated with the Wolf virion and it is type specific, while type the C antigen, it is associated with the non-infectious virus and less specific. Then the pathogenesis of this virus. Polio are a fecal-oral route. It can be transmitted by the fecal-oral route, which is followed by the respiratory, that is by inhalation, or rarely it can be infection is done by the conjunctival contact. Then they multiply in intestine, in epithelial cells, submucosal lymphoid tissue, tonsil and Peyer's patches. Viral entry into the host cell is mediated by binding to CD155 receptor, which is present on the host surface. Then virus can be spread to the CNS or spinal cord. The first route is through blood, hematogenous spread, which is most common, where virus spread to the regional lymph node and spills over to the bloodstream, where it can be cause the primary viremia. After this, the reticuloendothelial system, the virus enters the bloodstream again, that causing the secondary viremia. Then it is carried to the spinal cord and brain. The another spread of that is a neural spread, that in that virus may also spread directly through the nerves. This occurs specially following tonsillectomy. Site of the action. The final target site for poliovirus is motor nerve ending, that is anterior horn cell of the spinal cord, which leads the muscle weakness and flaccid paralysis. Neuron virus infected neurons undergo degeneration. The earliest change in the neuron is the degeneration of the nasal body. Virus can be shed through the feces. So this is one of the laboratory diagnosis where you can collect the specimen like feces and can be isolate the virus. Then clinical manifestation. The incubation period is usually of 7 to 14 days. The manifestation may range from the asymptomatic stage to the most severe paralytic stages. The first and the broad category of this clinical manifestation is asymptomatic infection, that is also called the inapparent infection. The following infection, the majority of the cases are asymptomatic, that is a buildup of 91 to 96%. Then abortive infection, that is a buildup of 5% of the patient that develop the minor symptoms like fever, malaise, sore throat, anorexia, myalgia, and also the headache. Then non-paralytic poliomyelitis, it is seen in 1% of the patient, which is presented as aseptic meningitis. Then the most severe one is paralytic poliomyelitis. Here you can see the asymptomatic infection is 91 to 96 among 100. The 5% are abortive, that is less severe or the minor symptoms. Then in almost in 1%, there is a non-paralytic, paralytic, and encephalitis will be there. The most severe one is a paralytic poliomyelitis, which can be there is a less than 1% of the chances to get this infection. This is the least common, which is characterized by descending asymmetrical acute flaccid paralysis, that is called AFP. Proximal muscles are mostly affected earlier than the distal muscle. Paralysis starts with the hip, which is proceeds toward the extremities, which leads to the characteristic tripod site, which can be seen in this picture, where child sits with a flexed hip, both arms are extended towards the back for the support. Then sites involved can be spinal, bulbospinal, and bulbar. According to the nature of paralysis varies. Then biphasic causes. In children, the disease progression is typically biphasic, where aseptic meningitis occurs first, then patient goes to the recovery, and then again it returns of a fever with paralytic features after 1 to 2 days. Cranial nerves are also involved occasionally. However, there is no sensory loss. There are many risk factors like older children and adults, then in also the pregnant woman, then following heavy muscular exercise, person undergo the trauma at the time of CNS symptoms. Tonsillectomy is one of the risk factor to get this type of infection. Then post-polio muscle atrophy syndrome is also there, which it usually decades after the episode of paralytic poliomyelitis. So this is the clinical picture of a patient where muscles are commonly weakened by the polio. As you can see, the shoulder, the muscle behind the arm, the back muscle, then the muscle that lift the foot, muscle that straighten the knee, the muscle that straighten the bended hip. So you can see the specific posture of the patient when where patient can be of AFP, acute flaccid paralysis. Then lab diagnosis will be fall into three major category. The first and important is virus isolation, where the specimen collection in the poliovirus may be recovered from the throat swab and up to 1 week of illness, and from the rectal swab or stool sample up to 6 to 8 weeks. However, the long-term excretion has been observed in immunodeficient person, and also virus can be isolated from the CSF or blood in very rare cases. And also sewage testing is also be done for screening of sewage for detection of polio. It is routinely conducted under the polio eradication program. This is to verify whether the transmission is ongoing or interrupted. Then transport, this may be in a frozen condition. Then the cell line, the Primary monkey kidney cells are the most recommended cell lines, and the virus growth can be identified the CPE, cytopathogenic effect, that is appear into 3 to 6 days, where crenation or the degeneration of the entire cell sheet will be there, and also there is a antigen detection is there, or the you can also do the PCR by the virus isolated. You can see the viruses like here, etc. Then also you can do the antibody detection. There is both neutralizing antibody and complement fixation antibodies can be detected. Then PCR assay is another option for detection of this type of viral infection. The most important part of this lecture is vaccine. Sorry. A polio vaccine can be available as a Salk vaccine or Sabin. The route of the vaccine is injectable in the case of Salk, while Sabin there is a oral vaccine. The dose is 4 doses. The first 3 doses at 1 to 2 months in a gap, while the fourth one is booster after the 6 to 12 months in gap. In the case of oral, there is a total 5 doses. The first, that is 0 doses given at the birth. Then the 3 is at of 6, 10 and 14 weeks of the age, and the last the booster at 16 to 24 months. In NIS, that is National Immunization Schedule, there is a 6th and 14th week of the age you can given to the Salk or injectable polio vaccine, that is IPV. And OPV is at 0 at birth, then 6th, 10th and 14th week, and the booster one is on 16 to 24. Safety, that is relatively safer than the OPV in case of Salk, while the oral OPV is safe except in immunocompromised patient, pregnancy and old age. Efficacy of the IPV is 80 to 90%, while the in the case of OPV there is a 90 to 100% efficacy. IPV is relatively expensive in the compare of OPV. Duration of the protection in the IPV, there is a short, it needs the booster doses periodically, while OPV is long-lasting. In herd immunity is provided into OPV, which is due to fecal spread of the vaccine virus. Then local immunity, in IPV, that is a weakly stimulated, while in OPV, there is a strong stimulated due to IgA antibodies. Then storage condition, it should be stored at minus 20 degrees Celsius in the case of OPV, which is stabilizing MgCl2 and less than 5 pH. While in case of IPV, that is relatively stable, it don't require the fancy things. VAPP and VDPV, there is a zero chance in case of IPV, and there is in OPV, there is relatively more chance in comparison of IPV. That is VAPP. VAPP means vaccine associated paralytic poliomyelitis, and VDPV means vaccine derived polioviruses. Then PPI, polio eradication program, which is initiated in 1955 to 1956, where there is a mostly a OPV is given. Two rounds of PPI, that is pulse polio immunization, are scheduled in every year during the winter season. For example, 18 January and 11th March in 2018, where all children undergo the age of 5 years are vaccinated with OPV, irrespective of their OPV vaccination status. PPI does of bivalent OPV are considered as extra doses, and they do not replace the OPV doses received under the routine national immunization schedule. The AFP surveillance is also there, where acute flaccid paralysis surveillance will be done in PPI, that is pulse polio immunization, where Amitabh Bachchan is a brand ambassador of this pulse polio immunization. So at last, the take-home message is to take the OPV, and polio should be eradicated where there is a lots of government programs, and also a WHO like agencies can be run the program to eradicate this type of infection. So Welby says, be well, take oral polio vaccine, which tastes good, works fast, and prevents the polio. I hope you will like the lecture. Thank you.